Yo, what's good YouTube? It's Boardzy, and this is going to be a review of the Skypad 3.0 XL. I'm sure a lot of you guys are familiar with Skypad by now. Easily the most popular glass mousepad manufacturer, and they have come out with a new model, the XL 3.0. I'm going to be comparing this to one of their older 2.0 models and just giving you a general review of this new surface because it is pretty wild. But the first thing I'm going to mention is that this is an unbelievably expensive mousepad. It is only available on Kickstarter at the moment. I'm not sure why they say that they have all of them produced. They could just do like a pre-order, whatever. I'm not going to question it. This mousepad is 120 euro after shipping, which is around 135 USD. Let me know in the comments if 135 USD is quite an ask, even for a glass mousepad. But yeah, compared to the past surfaces, Skypad claims that this is bigger, faster, and thinner. The one that I'm going to focus on first is thinner, because this was one of my main problems with the original Skypad. Holy shit, it is quite hard to pick these up, but I hope that you can just see how much thinner, nearly half as thick. Fuck, this is really not cooperating. Well, trust me, the Skypad 3.0 is much thinner, and the advantage of this is, let me zoom my camera out a bit. Wow. You see, my forearm doesn't really sink in. While on the 2.0, you can see that there's just so much more height that my forearm is like, if these edges were sharp, I would just be cutting myself. Of course, since this is a glass mousepad, they don't have stitched edges, but they do have rounded edges, and there's not going to be any fraying since this is a piece of glass. The reason I chose to focus on the height of the Skypad 3.0 first, which I think is 3.2 millimeters, is that one of my main flaws with the old Skypad is it just feels like a hunk of glass as opposed to a mousepad. That's why so many people memed it as like a cutting board, while the 3.0 definitely, with its size and features, feels more like a mouse pad than just a slab of glass, which is something good to say about it. Now I'll talk about this surface, which is extremely fast. One of the faster ones that exists, period. This mouse pad is not the same as the old Skypads. I saw some theories out there that they slowed down new batches of the 2.0, so this will seem faster in relativity. It's some pretty interesting stuff. I don't know if there's truth behind it, but this surface is very smooth, almost polished feeling, as opposed to the old Skypads, which have a distinct frosted texture on them, which definitely gives you some control. But with the 3.0 and this completely smoothed out glass texture, you're basically on your own for stopping power. If you want to generate stopping power, it's going to have to come from your hand as opposed to the mousepad. And what I mean by that, if you don't understand, is one thing I did is I was actually putting my ring finger, pinky finger, and thumb on the mousepad to give myself a sense of control when swiping the mouse around. You can see my fingers are slightly hanging off of the edge. You obviously don't have to do something like that, but if you get this mousepad using your default settings, your just everything the same as your previous mousepad, even if that was a glass mousepad, I think you're still going to be in for a surprise when you realize just how fast this surface plays. I am somebody who tests a lot of mice and mouse pads, and I rarely feel like I have to change my sense, but I significantly lowered my sense to play on this mouse pad, and it was still feeling fast. For something like Fortnite mechanics, this was a great mouse pad, but for anything like actually precision aiming or even just hitting flicks consistently, I don't feel like this mousepad was doing me any favors. I know that there are some people who are ultra glass mousepad pilled, and in that case, yeah, this is a even faster version of the 2.0. So if you think this mousepad's going to be for you and you just want a slab of glass with infinite durability that is going to play faster than most likely anything you've tried before, then yeah, that is who I think the Skypad 3.0 is for. This is like beyond a luxury mouse pad at this point. This thing is just fucking crazy. Obviously, it was sent out for review since this is still on Kickstarter. And I think in the thumbnail, you can see the crazy package that they sent it in. I'm not one for the dramatics, really, but it was some extravagant packaging. And the mouse pad arrived perfectly safe. They do charge 20 euros for shipping, so I wonder what the customer shipping experience is going to be like. But based on my past experiences and what I've seen on the internet, very few, if any, people actually have their Skypads arrive shattered. Next thing I want to talk about before getting back to the speed is the size. This is a 500 by 400 millimeter pad, which is actually larger than their previous XL model. I would have compared it to that, but if you remember, I actually shattered my old XL model, which is why I've been comparing it to the even older green one. But yeah, I guess it makes sense that the price has increased since they are making a literally larger mousepad. I personally have no complaints with the 3.0 XL's size, and it's clear that the Skypad has grown a lot since their original release. Next thing I want to talk about is, I guess, who I think this mousepad is for, because as I mentioned before, the friction coefficients are extremely low. The overall speed and just how this mousepad plays is fucking fast. So I would say that this is going to be for people who play tracking heavy games, who are already used to something with ultra low friction. The initial friction is just incredibly low. Like, go on your mousepad right now and just try and move it very minuscule amounts to the left and right. You will just realize like how crazy low the friction is on this Skypad. So whether you're like a naturally shaky aimer or you're used to a mousepad providing friction to provide some stability, this mousepad is just the polar opposite of that. I want this to be like an interactive review. I want you to take your mouse and do circles on your mousepad. Like, you can just see how extremely low the friction is on the Skypad 3.0. And I'm not sure how well you'll be able to see the difference on 30 FPS video, but there is even a higher sense of control on the Skypad 2.0. So I would say that instead of 50% faster, this is probably 20% faster and 30% less control. If that makes sense. If it doesn't make sense, just pretend I didn't say it. If you have a mouse that is under 60 grams, I can't imagine, just based on my own experience, that this would be like the ideal mouse pad for you, because it just personally was too fast for me with mice this light. Even if you have a heavier mouse, this still isn't going to feel like a control pad, but obviously the weight of the mouse will give you a bit more control. I was enjoying this the most in-game with Zowie mice and just generally stuff that was a bit above 70 grams. And I hope I was able to explain just how fast this mouse pad is. The reason I didn't mention many other pads is it just doesn't compare to anything I've tried before. Maybe a faster Endgame Gear MPC 450 is like the one thing that sort of comes to mind. But the surface, though, this smoothed out glass, like I said, it is comfortable. I don't know if it will get sticky if it's humid out or if your hand sweats on it. That at least hasn't happened to me, but it has been pretty cold in my time testing the mouse pad. But like I said, I was able to drag my fingers on it for control, so it's obviously not heavily textured or abrasive. It's just a smooth piece of glass. It's a nearly perfect experience in terms of quality, aside from the one flaw that every non-cloth mouse pad has, which is that if there's a single speck of dust or a hair, just any tiny object that can either get on your mouse skates or on the surface of the mouse pad, or even in this case, since the mouse pad is so thin, under the mouse pad when you put it on your desk, you will be able to feel that. So you do want to have a microfiber cloth on hand, but even with that, it just gets annoying over time, randomly swiping, you're in your zone, and then bam, a fucking scraping sound. It's annoying, but there's really nothing that they can do about it. It happens when you have a glass mouse pad, so it's something to keep in mind. If you want to check out this mouse pad, I will have a link to the Kickstarter in the description. I think it's an affiliate link, but I'm not giving this mouse pad the seal of approval or really just a strong glowing recommendation. It is what it's advertised to be, but I just don't know how many people that's for, and especially if it is worth that hefty price tag. But yeah, if you do seem interested and want to check it out, then feel free to go ahead. But yeah, that's going to be all for this video. Like and sub if you enjoyed. Peace. Not my main, but definitely the most interesting mousepad I've tried in a while.